Good afternoon, everybody, and thanks for clicking on 5 News Web News. It is Friday, March 8th. I'm Brittany Hoke.
And I'm Matt Heckelin. Here are some of the top stories we've been following here on 5 News today. We're actually starting off with a major fire this morning in Barber County.
That's right. A garage fire started at around 7:15 this morning at Sisolak Truck Repair on Talbot Road in Bealington. A man was inside at the time, and he says that he was getting ready to work on a truck when he heard some type of explosion. Liquid propane was stored in the garage, so for safety measures, crews are letting it burn out, which could take 3 to 4 hours. Crews responded from Barber, Upshur, Randolph, and Preston counties. The Century Volga PSD tells us that because of this incident, customers from Audra State Park to Bealington are under a boil water advisory. Investigators are ruling the fire accidental. The garage is a total loss.
Well, 14 people were forced out of their Lewis County apartment when it caught fire yesterday afternoon. 4 o'clock yesterday, firefighters were called to the two-story building on Broad Street after the blaze started in a kitchen in an upstairs apartment. When they got there, they saw flames coming out of the side of the building with heavy smoke. That apartment has been ruled a total loss, and the 9 other apartments in the building all suffered water and smoke damage. No word on the estimated cost of that damage or when those tenants will be able to return to their homes. And a home in Marion County was destroyed early yesterday morning. Flames had taken over the home on Lofty Lane in the Montana Mines area before crews even got there. It happened a little before 3 o'clock. Now, according to the relative of the homeowners, 3 people were home at the time, but nobody was hurt. Apparently, the family who lived there woke up when a smoke detector started going off, and that's when they saw smoke coming from a wall in the living room. We're told the family was staying at a hotel last night. Again, when we hear anything official, we'll make sure to pass it along to you.
And an investigation is underway into an armed robbery in Boothsville, Marion County. We've learned from 911 dispatchers that the incident happened at around 8:45 last night at the Little Store in Boothsville. Sheriff's deputies on scene say that a man came in, said he had a gun, and took off on foot. We're not sure, though, what he got away with right now, so make sure you stay with 5 News and our website for more details.
Well, we're waiting for a word on how a 3-year-old girl is doing after she fell out of a second-story window in a building in downtown Clarksburg yesterday. Firefighters say it happened on South 5th Street at around 4:30. Now, HealthNet was called in to fly the girl to the hospital because of the height of which she fell. She was conscious while crews were there. We're going to have more details on that as well as soon as they are available. Meanwhile, a car came crashing to the ground in Lewis County yesterday afternoon with no driver behind the wheel. Here's what we know right now. Weston police tell us the parking area near 2nd and Water Street collapsed at around 2:30, and one car went down with it. Now, luckily, nobody was in the car at the time. There is no word on what exactly caused the ground to give way, but the fire department and Division of Highways crews were checking out the situation.
And a Harrison County woman has 2 years to pay more than $40,000 back to the school PTA that she embezzled it from. 36-year-old Melissa Wilfong's 1 to 10 year jail sentence was suspended for 5 years of probation. Wilfong was the Johnson Elementary PTA treasurer when she took more than $20,000 from the account. Now she must pay the school back $27,000, and she owes the Board of Education $14,000. She was also ordered to write letters of apology to the School Board of Education.
Well, some surprisingly strong numbers on the unemployment front this morning. U.S. employers added 236,000 jobs in February, cutting the unemployment rate down to 7.7% from 7.9% in January. That is the lowest unemployment rate in 4 years. The strong hiring shows that businesses are confident about the economy, despite higher taxes and government spending cuts. Wages also increased, and the job gains were led by the best construction hiring in 6 years. And let's take a quick look at what our newsroom's working on for tonight. For First at 5 and 5 News at 6, first up, 1 week after sequestration, has there been any impact? We talked to Senator Joe Manchin tonight.
Plus, are the new texting laws enough to get people to stop texting behind the wheel? Well, we're going to find out what a new study has to say. And it's a weekend warm-up to melt away the snow and those blues that you might be feeling. We're going to have a look at your forecast tonight on First at 5 and 5 News at 6.
You were suffering from the winter blues earlier this week.
Yeah.
It's all cured.
Pretty much gone now. Once we hit that 62, I think that it will completely thaw it out.
Melt away like butter. That's going to do it for us here. Be sure to tune in tonight for First at 5 and 5 News at 6. And until then,
have a great day, everybody.